Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to transform photos into the look of color pencil illustration drawings. You'll be able to automatically apply it to all of your photos. Before we begin, make sure you click that subscribe button to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. Open a photo that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one and the others from Shutterstock. To ensure that your results will look similar to mine, check its size and resolution. Press Alt-Control-I on Windows or Option-Command-I on a Mac. You could also go to Image and Image Size. Its width and height should be somewhere between 1,000 and 3,000 pixels, and its resolution should be 150 pixels per inch. I provided this paper texture for you to download. Its link is in my video's description or my project files. We'll place the paper texture onto the photo. If your Move tool isn't active, press V on your keyboard. Drag it onto the tab of the photo, and without releasing your mouse or pen, press and hold the Shift key as you drag it down and release. Holding Shift kept the texture centered over the photo. To resize and reposition it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. If your photo is vertical, you can rotate the texture by going to Edit, Transform, and Rotate clockwise. If you can't see the transform's entire bounding box, press Ctrl or Command 0. Go to a corner. If you're using a version earlier than CC 2019, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. If you're using a later version, just press Alt or Option as you drag it. Then press Enter or Return. Hide the texture and make your photo active. We'll convert it into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively and have the ability to replace it with another photo without having to redo the effects. Click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Sharpen, and Unsharp Mask. Basically, the Unsharp Mask filter sharpens an image by increasing contrast along its edges. It locates pixels that differ in value from surrounding pixels according to the threshold you specify. It then increases the contrast of neighboring pixels by the amount you specify. The greater the radius, the larger the edge effects. For this effect, the amount is 200%, the radius is 5 pixels, and the threshold is 0 levels. Go back to Filter, Stylize, and Oil Paint. The stylization is 2, and the cleanliness, scale, and bristle detail are all 10. The lighting is checked, the angle is 120 degrees, and the shine is 0.2. We'll convert this layer into a smart object. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Artistic folder and click Rough Pastels. The stroke length is 4 and the stroke detail is 6. The texture is sandstone, the scaling is 100%, the relief is 30, and the light is top left. We want to reduce the opacity of the pastel effect. To do this, double-click the Filter Gallery's Blending Options icon and type in 50% for its opacity. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Go to Filter, Stylize, and Find Edges. Change the blend mode to soft light and reduce its opacity to 80%. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. In this layer, we'll create another texture. Press Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open your Fill window. You could also go to Edit and Fill. Open the Contents list and click 50% Gray. go to Filter, Noise, and Add Noise. Make the amount 50%, Gaussian, and monochromatic. Change the blend mode to soft light. Notice how this texture adds a subtle pebble-like feel to our drawing. Make the paper texture visible and active. Change its blend mode to overlay and reduce its opacity to 80%. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.